Oftentimes, with all the hoopla over the latest, biggest, and the best, we overlook the simple and the basic. And sometimes the basic is surprisingly good. Now, you could call these simple, basic ATVs by a lot of different names, but basically, they are top sellers. The reason for that is twofold. First, they're a lot cheaper than the big bore class ATVs all loaded down with technology. And two, they're just downright good values. Now, in the case of the new Suzuki King Quad 400, you basically got an ATV that's been around for a while, and that usually means there's been plenty of time to get all the bugs worked out. Now, in the case of the new King Quad 400, you'll find an ATV that's been around as a great, if ugly, ATV by the name of the Eiger. Now, climbing on the King Quad 400, you're going to be amazed at just how good it feels. Goldilocks would love it, as it's just the right size. The seat is comfortable, and the distance to the handlebars and the foot pegs is just about perfect. The floorboards are a bit of a distance below the foot pegs, giving plenty of space for mud and water to fall from your feet on the pegs, and yet adding a much-needed safety net around the pegs. Now, in front of you is a small analog speedometer and odometer with a resettable trip odometer just below it. Also on the gauge pod are the reverse, neutral, and water temperature lights. The ignition key is located just below the gauge pod, with the fuel gauge located on top of the fuel tank, just behind the filler. Now on the right front fender is a 12-volt accessory outlet. On the handlebar, just to the right of the gauges, is the flip lever to switch between two-wheel drive and four-wheel drive. And on the right handlebar is the obvious thumb throttle and the lever for the front brakes. On the left handlebar is the lever for the rear brakes, as well as a simple locking mechanism for the parking brake. Also on the left handlebar is the sliding choke lever, the light switch, starter button, and the emergency kill switch. The air-cooled 376cc four-stroke single-cylinder engine is fed by a single Keyan carburetor. The automatic transmission is a CVT unit with a sub-transmission allowing for high range, low range, neutral, and reverse, all selectable via a gated lever on the left side of the ATV. The shift gate's operation, the precision, and the overall feel of shifting between the gears is one of the nicest and smoothest units on any ATV. The engine braking is unnoticeable in its operation, feeling as much like the slowing of a geared transmission as any CVT can. The 4.2-gallon fuel tank is conventionally placed above the engine in front of the seat. The King Quad 400 uses a conventional dual cradle frame. The brakes are a pair of discs up front and a single mechanically operated drum on the right side of the rear axle. The front and rear brakes are operated independently by the handlebar levers and the right foot pedal and have great feel and stopping power. The foot pedal is positioned so it can be quickly and easily operated by even the slightest move of your foot. Suspension is dual A-arms up front with 6.7 inches of travel. The rear suspension is a simple steel swing arm with a pair of non-adjustable preload shocks and 6.7 inches of travel. The racks on the King Quad are nice, tubular metal, but as on every Suzuki utility ATV, the front is a very small, and it's hindered by a rear hoop that dramatically limits the size of the front bag or box that can be fastened to it. The rear differential skid plate extends behind the differential just enough to also be used as a mounting location for the trailer hitch. The good, surprisingly smooth engine, great shifting and working transmission, and a great size with wonderful ergonomics. And the small size adds a lot of confidence in that difficult terrain. The bad? No locking front differential, no preload adjustments on the shocks, too small a front rack to be of much good, plus I guess we're getting spoiled by fuel injection that it lacks. The bottom line? A great-sized ATV that does everything so well it makes you wonder why you would even need a bigger ATV.
you want more information on the products, ATVs, or adventures featured in today's show, make sure you check out our website at atvtv.com.